यूनिट टू लोडर्स एंड लिंकर्स पार्ट सो दिस डायग्राम शोज द रिलेशन बिटवीन द लिंकर एंड द लोडर द सोर्स प्रोग्राम इज गिवन टू द असेंबलर देन द ऑब्जेक्ट कोड इज गिवन टू द लिंकर एंड देन एग्जीक्यूटेबल कोड इज गिवन टू द लोडर सो दिस इज ऑल्सो डायग्राम फॉर द लिंकर्स एंड लोडर्स Here three source files are given to the three compiler or assembler. Then it is given to the object code file, then to the linker, and finally to the object code file is then given to the loader, and it will give to the main memory or for the execution. So what is The definition of linker. Linker means it is a program that takes as input the output file. That takes as the input the object file of one or more separately compiled program modules, and then links them together into complete executable program, resolving reference from one module to another. And what is loader? Loader means a program that takes an input, an executable program, loads it into the main memory and causes the execution to begin by loading the correct starting address into the computer register. When the program finished, the control must somehow be returned to the operating system. So, a source program is converted to the object program by assemblers and compilers, and the loader is the program which accepts the object code and prepare them for the execution and initiates the execution. As many as four functions are performed by the loader. These functions are, one is allocation. Allocation means it is of space in main memory for the program. Linking of object module with each other. The linking involves resolving of symbolic references between object modules and adjust all address dependent locations such as address constant to correspond to the allocated space. It is also called relocation, physically loading the machine instruction and data into the main memory. So this is loader, and what is linking? Any usable program which is written in any language has to use the functions or the subroutines. These functions could be either user defined functions or they can be library functions. For example, consider a program written in C language. Such a program may contain call to functions like printf or scanf. During the program execution, the main program as well as the function must reside in the main memory. In addition, every time a function is called, the control should get transferred to the appropriate function. So the linking process makes address of module known to each other so that transfer of control takes place during the execution. The passing of parameter is handled by the linker. The parameter can be passed by the value or by the reference. A value returned by a function must be handled. Every public variable should have the same address in every module. An external variable can be defined in one module and it can be used in another module. The address of an external variable should be same in every module. Resolving of the address of symbolic references are handled by the linker. Next is, what is relocation? The relocation is the process of modifying the address which is used in the address sensitive instructions of program such that the program can execute correctly from any designated area of the memory. So consider the statement mover area AREGX. So this is an address sensitive instruction. For this instruction to execute correctly, the actual address of X should be put in the instruction. So assume the program written in C language calls a function F1, and the program A and the function F1 must be linked with each other. So there is a basic loader functions, that is we have already seen, that is allocating or allocation, linking, relocation and loading. Allocation means it allocate a space in a memory for the program. Linking means it resolves the symbolic references between the object files. Also, it combines two or more separate object programs. It supplies the information needed to allow a reference between them. Relocation, it adjusts all the address-dependent locations such as address constant to correspond to the allocated space. Loading means it physically places the machine instruction and data into the memory. So, for case 1, at the time of translation, A has been given a storage area from 100 to 250, while F1 occupies area between 400 to 500. If we were to load this program at their translated address, then lot storage line between them will be wasted. And second case is, at the time of translation, both A and F1 may have been translated with identical start address 100. A goes from 100 to 250 and F1 from 100 to 200. These two modules cannot coexist at the same storage locations. The loader must relocate A and F1 to avoid address conflict or storage waste. A possible relocation So, it may be noted that relocation is more than simply moving a program from one area to another in the storage. It refers to the adjustment of the address field and not to the movement of the program. Next is types of loader. So based on the various functionalities of loader, there are various types of loader: compile, assemble and go loader, general loader and absolute loader. So first is the absolute loader. Absolute loader is a kind of loader in which relocated object files are created. The loader accepts these file and places them at specified location in the memory. This type of loader is called absolute because no relocation information is needed. Rather, it is obtained from the programmer or assembler. Assembler should have the knowledge of memory management. So this diagram shows the process of absolute loader or absolute loading. The absolute loader only performs a loading function. It does not need to perform linking. All the functions are accomplished in a single pass. Absolute loader. So, the task of absolute loader is virtually trivial. The loader simply accepts the machine language code produced by an assembler and places it into a main memory at the location specified by the assembler. So the main program is assigned to the locations of 100 to 250 and the function F1 is assigned the locations. The programmer should be careful not to design overlapping location to module to be linked. There are four loading functions that are accomplished in an absolute loading scheme: allocation by programmer, linking by programmer, relocation by assembler, and loading by loader. So there are some advantages of absolute loading scheme. The first advantage is no relocation information is required, so the size of the object module is comparatively small. This scheme is very simple to implement. This scheme makes more memory available for loading since the assembler is not in the memory at the time of loading. There is no modification of address sensitive entities is required at the time of loading. And this scheme supports a multiple object modules to reside in memory. Now there are some disadvantages of absolute loader. Since the linking is handled by the programmer has to remember the address of each module and use that absolute address explicitly for linking. The programmer has to be careful not to assign overlapping locations to modules to be linked. Lot of memory lying between modules will be wasted if the changes are made to one module that increases its size, then it can overlap the start of another module. It may require a manual shifting of module, and this manual shifting can become very complex and tedious. So the absolute loader loads the object code to the specified location in the memory. At the end of the loader, it jumps to the specified address to begin execution of the loaded program. Advantage: simple and efficient. Disadvantage: the need for the programmer to specify the actual address, and difficulty in using subroutine libraries. Next is bootstrap loader. So when a computer is first turned on or restarted, a special type of absolute loader called bootstrap loader is executed. This bootstrap loads the first program to be run by the computer, usually an operating system. The bootstrap itself begins at address 0. There is one more link, subroutine linkage. A program consisting of main program and set of functions could reside in several files. These program units are assembled separately. The problem of subroutine linkage in this, a main group A wishes to call a subroutine B, and if subroutine B resides in another file, then the assembler will not know the address of B and declare it as an unidentified symbol. To realize such interactions, A and B must contain a public definition and external references. So the extrn statement, this statement lists the symbol to which external references are made in the current program unit. These symbols are defined in other program units. This another entry statement lists the public definition of the program unit, that is, it lists those symbols defined in a program unit which may be referenced in other program units. So the design of absolute loader. In absolute loading scheme, the programmer and the assembler perform the following tasks, that is, allocation, relocation and linking. The absolute loader reads the object program line by line and moves the text of the program into the memory at the location specified by the assembler. The object program generated by the assembler must communicate the following information to the loader. It must convey the machine instruction that the assembler has created along with the memory address. It must convey the starting execution point. The program execution will start at this point after the program is loaded. The object program is sequence of object record. Each object record specifies some specific aspect of the program in the object module. There are two types of record: the text record containing binary image of the assembly program and the transfer record containing the starting point of execution. So the algorithm for absolute loader is very simple. The loader reads the object file record by record and moves the binary image at the location specified in the record. The last record in the transfer record. On reaching the transfer record, the control is transferred to the entry point for execution.